Away in a manger, no crib or a bed. The little Lord Jesus lay down his sweet head. The stars in the skies look on where he lay. The little Lord Jesus asleep on that hay. Oh, what a sacred night. The stars were shining bright. The angels singing loudly. The Savior has arrived. The music filled the skies. Oh, what a lullaby. To announce the newborn baby to people far and nigh. And they cried, glory, 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 to the Lord God on high. All the angels cried, glory, 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 to the Lord God on high.
You know, I just imagine a lot of these people wonder what goes on at the pastor's house on Christmas, at Christmas time.
Well, We begin with the four F's.
Four F's? What are the four F's?
Well, the first F is family. We have lots of love in our family for each other and for our oldest son, Christopher, Lorella, his wife, and Leslie and Carter, their two girls, and for our youngest son, Jason, and his wife, Jill, and their daughter, Juliana. The second F is, of course, friends. We have lots of friends here. You guys are our best friends. We have shared many happy Christmas events with you. The third F is food. We begin our Christmas day with a cheese ball. We munch on that all through the morning while we're waiting for our son to come home from work. And then at lunchtime in the early afternoon, our tradition is steak and shrimp. Of course, we lived in Louisiana for so long, we love shrimp. And the meal would not be complete without our favorite dessert. We call it Hello Dollies. Then, no Christmas would be complete without football, the fourth F. Our favorite team is the New Orleans Saints, of course. Even God supports the Saints. Sorry, Brother Ed.
Oh. And you know what comes after F.
What's that?
G. For gifts. Yes. Oh. And you know our granddaughters, they love the gifts. And you can't have Christmas without the gifts. Watch this video.
Tick tock, tick tock, tick tock. The tricky clock tick tocking, each painfully long minute unlocking. The tumbly jumbly can't close your eyes feeling. What will it be? When will it be? Oh, the anticipation, the watching, the wishing and waiting, to let the wiggles and giggles and goosebumps go, to find, to see, to finally know. What will it be? When will it be? Oh, the expectation, the what-ifs, the oh-my's fairly shaking, longing for this night's joy all year, that moment of hope so very near. Oh, but would they, could they, imagine a gift so great, a gift that compelled the whole world to wait? When a heavenly Father gave all mankind his Son, the one love defined. The magic of Christmas is more brilliant, you see, than a bag or a box tucked under a tree. The true love of Christmas really began when holy God became holy man.
Joseph, it's time. He's here.
Getting cold, it's warm inside. family drawing near. Christmas time is here. So I say Merry Christmas, I wish peace to you. I hope for the hopeless, your dreams come true. And I pray for the laughter, I sing through the tears. I say Merry Christmas for all the world to hear. The smell of evergreen, a wooden manger scene, a starry night so clear. Christmas time is here. So I say Merry Christmas, I wish peace to you. I hope for the hopeless, your dreams come true. And I pray for the laughter, I sing through the tears. I say Merry Christmas for all the world to hear. Disappear. Christmas time is here. So I say Merry Christmas, I wish peace to you. I hope for the hopeless, your dreams come true. And I pray for the laughter, I sing through the tears. I say Merry Christmas for all the world. I say Merry Christmas, I wish peace to you. I hope for the hopeless, your dreams come true. And I pray for the laughter, I sing through the tears. I say Merry Christmas for all the world to hear.
Another tradition that we have at our home at Christmas time begins well before Christmas. I have a baby doll. I find that doll each year and lay it in a box on a bed of hay and wrap the gift. On Christmas Day, when it's time to open the gifts, we draw a name, and someone's name is chosen to open the first and best gift of Christmas. Sometimes it's Chris, sometimes it's Pastor. As they open the box, inside, they will find a baby doll. And with it, they will find a birth certificate. We read the birth certificate of our Savior, Jesus Christ. We know He is the best gift of Christmas. But you know, I wonder, how did the angels feel about Jesus being our Christmas gift? Let's take a look.
I hate it when you do that.
Hey, fear not, my friend. I bring you good news of... Okay, no news, just coffee.
Thanks. Decaf, right?
Yep, got you the unleaded stuff.
I keep telling you, you gotta cut back on the caffeine.
What's the real stuff gonna do? Shorten my lifespan? Want me to cut down? I can cut down.
Hey, come on, cut it out.
Chill, bro. I'm just having a little fun. What is it with you and these people anyway?
What do you mean?
I don't know, it just seems like you like them or something. I mean, personally, I don't know what you see in them. I don't know what the boss sees in them. I mean, they're not exactly the sharpest tools in the shed, right?
I'm aware they've had their moments. Still.
Oh, haven't you heard the latest?
Oh, I've been on assignment.
Check this out. He wants to become one of them.
One of who?
You know, them.
He does?
I know. It's weird, right?
So, what? He's gonna become a president or something like that?
No, see, that's the even crazier part, is he's gonna come as a baby. He's even got the parents picked out, but no one's special. They're not even married yet. Do you realize that means that he's gotta get born? Like a human birth. Have you ever seen that?
Yeah, well, he's always doing stuff you don't expect.
You know what? I think it's a bad idea. Coming down as a baby? Doesn't he know what they're like? I mean, who knows what they'll do to him?
I bet he's got a plan. He always does.
Besides, we won't let anything bad happen to him.
You really think they're worth the risk? You can never tell what humans are going to do next. One minute they're like, oh, save me, Lord, I'll do anything. And the next minute they're sneaking off, going to do the same thing that got them into trouble in the first place. They're so... Oh.
I get what you're saying. I do. But you know, as I've watched them, I've seen something. I've seen compassion, joy, a sense of wonder. And yeah, they're broken and messed up, and they need someone to save them from themselves. So are they worth the risk? I don't know. I guess. But it doesn't really matter what we think. All that really matters is what he thinks. And he thinks they're worth it.
You know, normally at Christmas time, we read that birth certificate, and our granddaughters are here, and we read the Christmas story. But since our granddaughters have moved away, I've asked Blake and Mariah to come and help me read the Christmas story. Blake, Mariah, come on. Oh, there you are. A virgin will be with child and give birth to a son, and will call him Emmanuel.
And he will be called Wonderful Counselor, Mighty God, Everlasting Father, Prince of Peace. increase of his government and peace, there will be no end. The zeal of the Lord Almighty will accomplish this.
God sent an angel, Gabriel, to Nazareth, a town in Galilee, to a virgin, pledged to be married to a man named Joseph. The virgin's name was Mary.
The angel went to her and said, "Greetings, you are highly favored. The Lord is with you. Do not be afraid, Mary. You have found favor with God. You will be with child and give birth to a son, and you are to give him the name Jesus. Caesar Augustus issued a decree that a census should be taken of the entire Roman world. And everyone went to his own town to register. So Joseph went up from the town of Nazareth to Bethlehem, because he belonged to the house and line of David.
He went there to register with Mary, who was expecting a child. While they were there, the time came for the baby to be born, and she gave birth to her firstborn, a son. She wrapped him in clothes and placed him in a manger. Hey, good job, guys and girls. Thank you so much. I think y'all did as good a job as my granddaughters did. All right? Hey, and while you're here, you know, we love all the kids at CCC. And if someone will go tell Sarah to come out with the kids, I'd appreciate it. And because we have gifts for all the kids, and I'm going to ask Blake and Mariah to help me pass out the gifts. Come here, guys. You can take two at a time.
Thank you.
Forget the real meaning of Christmas. We have to do many things to keep reminding ourselves over and over what Christmas really means. Check this out.
It's Christmas time again. The snow is falling. Well, in some places, with noses glowing like a certain reindeer. It's time to whip out the winter britches and forage for the family Christmas tree. It's time for snowmen and snow angels and a tumble down the white powdered slope. It's Christmas with distractions all around. Between shopping, wrapping, eating, and traveling, we end up wrapped up in our own holiday avalanche, trying to get out alive. Stop. Think. What is the real miracle of Christmas? It is God's only Son, the Savior, our Redeemer, the miracle of the Messiah, Emmanuel, God with us, the Word in flesh, dwelling among us. Kneel before the King of Kings and know the wonder of His love. Because this is more than a holiday. This is Christmas.
Hallelujah.
time of year that we love to show and to express our love to special people. There are people here today who are so special to me. These worship team members, they have worked all through the year, week after week. They come for practice and they don't complain. They don't fuss with each other. That's just a big blessing to this pastor. And we want to show our appreciation to the worship team with just small token to help them to remember and know how much they are loved. I know who this is. Yes, you may open. There's a trash can right behind you.
Oh, that is.
Oh, yeah, that's not the right one.
What's the time? Let's see. Nope.
Look down there on the floor. See that? Right there.
Maybe she didn't get one. Maybe
she did. Open. Y'all can open. There's a trash can right back there. There's a trash can right back there behind you. And you can put the gifts on that stool so that you can sing. While they open, I'm going to sing for you the Song of Mary.
Sing for you.
You know, not everyone will have a great Christmas. There are service men and women serving our country on battlefields. Spotlight. There they are. On battlefields. And that's rough. I remember my first Christmas. I was sleeping in the attic of a military building that first Christmas. And it was not that wonderful. But I remember a story I heard about soldiers serving during the wartime in World War I. Let's watch it.
Jenkins, Oakley.
Knight.
My name is Jim.
My name is Otto.
Pleased to meet you, Otto.
Like me.
Rose, she's called.
I'm Schoen.
Someday at Christmas, men won't be boys, playing with bombs like kids play with toys. One warm December, our hearts will see a world where men Christmas, there'll be no wars. When we have learned what Christmas is for, when we have found what life's really worth, there'll be peace on earth. Someday all our dreams will come to be. Someday in a world where men are free. Maybe not in time for you and for me, but someday at Christmas time. Someday at Christmas we'll see a land with no hungry children and no empty hands. One happy morning people will share.
Lot to our soldiers who defend our borders, and really they give us the right to worship and celebrate the way we want. But you know, I got to thinking, we, that's you and I, owe a lot to several people around here, because we don't do everything to make this church run smooth. Other people are involved. And I think we have some gifts under the tree over there for them.
You call the names, I'll pick it.
Hello? Just leave them both on. We have a special person who works and does a lot every week for us, and that is John Comte. Would you come up, John? He runs our sound back there and takes care of our tech, and he comes here. If something breaks down, he fixes it for us. Awesome job, John.
Thank you, John.
You want to open it?
Yeah.
You have to open it.
We're opening.
Oh, I'll shake your hand too.
Yeah,
Merry Christmas. Yeah, you have to open it up here. Turn around. Rebecca, come up here.
You have it. Come here. Okay. That's
fine. Music. That's a Christmas ornament, John, if you don't know what that is. You know, single guy, and what is this they're giving me? Thank you, sir. Blake!
You have to buy a tree next year, John.
Mr. Blake is my go-get'em.
We send Blake to the third floor several times almost every Sunday. He's also faithful to carry our computers for us back and forth to our cars.
Yeah, you got to open it. Joey. Hold it up, what'd you get? Oh, beautiful. Thank you, Rebecca. Just say David.
Nice job.
David.
Can I go back?
Yes.
Yeah, you can go back. Yes. David.
David was one of our Sunday school teachers.
Yeah, Sunday school teacher. And Joey over there was a Sunday school teacher also, plus he works on tech. David taught our Sunday school class for a long time on Sunday mornings. Thank you, David.
And Joey's our fill-in
pastor. Whoa, 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 whoa. You got to stay here just like everyone else. Yeah, yeah, yeah. Paul Evans, that's him. Paul Evans keeps me straight on my sermons. He lets me know if I use the scripture wrong.
He's our political
but
action man.
He does all of our political action movement, encouraging people, bringing us the paperwork to sign up and everything else. And we want to say thank you for that part.
We still have a few more here. Let's see what we've got.
Who?
Kent.
Oh, Kent. He thought he was getting left out. Anyone else? That was it?
No.
Okay.
No.
Yeah, I got those. Kent works faithfully. He takes care of our website, updates it. He takes care of our live streaming and also on YouTube, putting it on. He does all of that stuff. I never touch it. You tape those shut?
Because they were big and they, I didn't want them to.
Running rocks with Santa Claus. Then we have some other very special people. Oh, I don't know. Really? Sarah? Hostetler? Oh, Sarah! This lady has stuck with us through thick and thin. And she's done our tech, run our sound. She's ran our lights. She's taking care of the nursery. Awesome lady. Thank you, Sarah.
Is Rika here?
She needs some training on how to open presents. This is a rehearsal for Thursday. A lot of tape. Oh, an angel. And then we have, Rika Joy's not here. We have another young lady who takes care of our nursery on Tuesday nights. Her name is Rika Joy. She's not here today. She attends New Hope on Sunday nights. Ed.
What?
And that's not the horse. Come up here.
You got the wrong one.
Ed.
Which Ed? There are two Eds there.
Ed.
He
is one of our board members, and we want to thank you for your faithful service. And to let you know, he is retiring from the board this year. At our business meeting, we'll be selecting a new board member. Ed said he's becoming 84, and that was enough, and so we reluctantly accepted.
It's not a ticket to Hawaii.
No. He's always saying he wants to have a board meeting in Hawaii, but that's not your ticket to Hawaii, Ed. I'll take your paper. Thank you. Bless you. Love you, man.
Bless you. We love you, Ed.
Watch your step going down. We don't want to use it. Alan Perkins. Another one of our board members. Serving faithfully. One of the financial gurus. Oh, I shouldn't say that. That's not negative. That's positive. Thank you, Brother Ed. Brother Ed. Yeah, Brother Alan.
Thank you, Brother.
Thank you. Thank you very much.
And then lastly, we have our other board member, Hilda. Would you come, please? No. Here in the light. She is another one of the financial experts of checking all the details in the board meetings, financial reports. I got it.
Thank you, Mr. Fred.
Oh, you're quite welcome, my lady. You're worth it.
Thank you for all you do.
Merry Christmas to you.
And while we have been giving out gifts, I think it's a good time for you to be get ready to give your gifts to the kingdom of the Lord. Alan and Rachel, would you come, please? Alan. Rachel. It's offering time. Time for you to give your gifts. That's your gifts to the Lord. Go ahead. I don't think we have any music. Special music for this. You have something to say?
Belinda has
something. Oh, Belinda has something to say.
Can you turn this microphone on?
Hello? Okay.
I'm honored to be the person
that gets to talk for the church. I was asked to do something very nice for our pastors. We don't appreciate them as often as we should. I've been here a few years and we've never taken up anything for our pastors. They do so much. Pastor Fred practically lives here. And you all helped make this possible. We want you guys to know that we love you. We really appreciate all that you guys do. They have been my parents this year. I've had a tough year, and I was able to smile through everything because of Pastor Fred and Pastor Linda. If you guys haven't had a chance to just sit and spend time with them, you are missing out. Enjoy our pastors while they're here. This is to tell you guys thank you for everything that you do.
Thank you, Belinda.
I gave the pastors a bucket. Half of it's filled with really nice cookies. The other half is cold for Pastor Fred. But God bless you, Pastor Fred and Pastor Linda. It's not a lot, but it's what we could do.
Thank you.
Thank you, church. Thank you.
Open it.
Don't let it fall. I'll open it. Oh, wow. They got it hooked, and I can't pull it out.
If anybody's interested in what happened in the envelope, see me after church and I'll let you guys know what we did for them.
You read that at home.
Oh, read that at home, she said. She said, read at home.
The card you can read, but the letter you can...
Thank you. God's an awesome God.
Yes, he is. Praise the
Amen.
Lord.
Read the card. Read the card. That's a beautiful. I'll pick that card. That's a really nice
stuff
card.
In the way.
I'll read you some.
Okay.
Today in the town of David, a Savior is born to you. He is Christ the Lord. Luke 2:11. Pastors, a special wish for a joyous season filled with God's love and blessings. Merry Christmas.
That was much better. I could hear it finally. John
I'm glad
to,
you know sign language.
John
now
is supposed to put you in the monitors full blast when you're speaking and I'm interpreting. But that it right here works very well.
There you go.
Thank you, church.
Thank you.
Their refrigerator broke down this week, so we blessed them, you guys.
I don't know what goes next.
I don't either.
Oh, remember to be thankful.
Hurting at Christmas time. Not everyone will experience a joyful Christmas this year. Some are homeless, like we saw in the video. Some don't have money to buy their children things at Christmas. Some have lost a loved one this year. And Christmas at their home will be empty. Instead of full of joy, it might be full of tears. We need to remember those who hurt at Christmas time.
But you know, with love, we can light up a dark world. How do we do that? We give light by hugs, smiles, and telling the story of Jesus Christ. That brings hope to people who have no hope.
prophet told us long ago, a child will come to bring us home, a star lit up the night to show the way. Oh, oh, oh. For all the wise men seeking truth, the child came as living proof, the light of all the world still shines today. In a lowly cattle stall, love was born to save us all. It's a season of hope, a season of joy, and it all goes back to a baby boy. When God reached down and changed the world forever, we can reach out, we can believe, in the power of love we can all meet a need, and love can change the world forever.
Love can change the world,
behind the lights and the Christmas cheer, people try their fear. Many hungry hearts are lost in gold. But we can be the light of Christ, bring some joy to someone's life, and share the greatest story ever told. In a lowly cattle stall, to save us all. It's a season of hope, a season of joy, and it all goes back to a baby boy. When God reached down and changed the world forever, we can reach out, we can believe in the power of love, we can all meet a need, and love can change the world forever.
Yes, it can.
Oh yeah.
Love can change the world.
Love can change the world.
Yes, it can.
We are His hands, we are His feet, across a thousand miles or across your street. We are His hands, we are His feet, across a thousand miles or across your street. We've got a gift, let's give it away. Make a difference today. It's a season of hope, a season of joy, and it all goes back to a baby boy. When God reached down and changed the world forever, we can reach out, we can believe in the power of love. We can all meet a need, and love can change the world. Change the world.
cannot handle. For the old man who's staring at a frosty window pane, light a candle. For the woman who is lonely, every Christmas is the same. For the children who need more than presents can bring, light a candle. Light the dark, light the world, light a heart too. Light a candle for me, light a candle for you.
Light a candle,
light a candle
for the homeless and the hungry, a little shelter from the cold. Light a candle for the broken and forgotten. May the season warm their souls. Can we open our hearts to shine through the dark?
Light a candle, light the dark, light the world.
On earth surround us here and teach us there's a better way to live. Oh, and with every flame that burns, we must somehow learn
the love's the greatest gift that we could ever give.
Must be lit is in the heart of every human on the earth. Only the love of Jesus Christ can light that candle. We are here today to offer you Jesus. Maybe you're not feeling the joy light burning in your heart today. Maybe you feel hopeless or helpless. Jesus is the answer for that. Could be you don't know how to relate to Jesus. Maybe you've been in church all your life and you have never learned how to really relate to Him. It's simple. Just open your heart and say, in simple words, Jesus, I know you came to die for my sins. I'm sorry. Forgive me. I will live all of my life for you. I know it won't be easy. I will need your help. But with your help, I can change my life. Jesus, I know you came to be my Savior. I accept your gift of love today. I want to always proclaim that you are my Savior. Amen.
Amen.
If your heart said that prayer with me today, welcome to the family of God.
Yes. Hallelujah.
Join us in singing this last song, Come and Worship.
Come and worship.
Neil. Now that you know what a little bit about what happens at the pastor's house on Christmas, and I know that you all have your own traditions in what you do. It varies from family to family. It varies. But now you get a little bit of a glimpse of what we really do on Christmas Day. And now we want you to make sure that you celebrate, rejoice, and have a Merry Christmas. Amen. Joey has an announcement.
Lights on. Okay, we're finished here. We will be going to Leche Bookstore Cafe over there on Firestone. If you don't know where it is, ask us. We know. We'll give you the direction. We'll be fellowshipping together. We'll be eating over there. And we're also having a fun game, the White Elephant game. If you guys forgot your gifts, you have a little bit of time to hurry up and buy something, wrap it up. And Brandon, no, you don't have to. It's fine. I hope to see all of you there, okay? God bless you, and Merry Christmas to you.
Merry Christmas.
These ones right here, I want to take to the Leche Cafe. These ones. Just leave the kids ones. Okay.